Hello and welcome everyone. Today we will try to understand the function of a pinch roll in cold rolling mills or processing lines. So first I'll tell you the use of it, and then next I have a video which is taken from a 6-high cold rolling mill which illustrates the functions of a pinch roll, the movements that it can do. So the basic function of a pinch roll is to push the steel strip, let's say the material, in a particular direction. I mean, it can only move forward or reverse. So it helps in feeding the steel strip in a straight direction. So when you have a pinch roll, you can have it either in engaged condition or in a disengaged condition. So while the strip is being fed, the operator keeps it in an engaged condition. And the advantage of keeping it in an engaged condition is that it helps in feeding the strip in a straight direction and avoids sidetracking of the strip while feeding. And generally it is driven by a hydraulic motor or AC motor also in processing lines. And the safety interlocks that are generally present are that is when the line is running at high speeds, pinch rolls must necessarily be in a disengaged or in up condition. So generally, in general, what you see as a practice is that in processing lines, pinch rolls are disengaged or in up condition when speeds are greater than 30 mpm. In cold rolling mills, pinch rolls are kept in disengaged condition before running the line. However, there is no very hard and fast rule. Functionality depends on the application requirements. But yes, there is only one rule, that when you are running at high speeds, your pinch roll must be in disengaged condition. Let's have a look at the video next.